It's Monday the 30th of January 2017. Good morning and welcome to today's United Kingdom talk. Poor old Adam's not too well today, are you, sir? He's got a bad back. He's off work today with a bad back. Oh, any excuse, Adam, dear. Any excuse to have time off work? I'm shocked and horrified. I thought you was like me, soldiering through all sorts of illnesses and broken this and sneezing and all that sort of thing. Disappointed in you, Adam. What are people supposed to do? Adam is a very famous London plumber who will come and sort your pipeworks out for a very reasonable not even a call out charge. Nothing like that. Hope you get well soon, Adam. Let's say hello to the early people this morning. Gustav says, I see you've been fiddling with your software. I do hope you like our little opening countdown, which you only see if you're watching the show live. If you're watching the show recorded, it's a bit pointless putting it on there. But yes, that 5-minute countdown is to allow people to see, oh, there's something happening. Let's join in. So, you know, you don't miss anything at the beginning. I know what you like, missing things, Gustav. Now, you did say, Gustav, that you were popping down to the karaoke last Friday to have a little squeeze of my bum, and you didn't come. I'm very, very disappointed. I walked around the venue for hours, not a single squeeze from anyone. Very, very disappointing, Gustav. Promises are made and they are not kept. Not like me, where I give you promises. All promises are kept at all times. Thank you. Can we just do a quick happy birthday here? Usually all the birthdays are generally at the end of the show, boys and girls. But when it is a superstar, we must do the birthday at the beginning. And that is Tony Blackburn, Radio London. It was his birthday yesterday. We can't go into details of ages or anything like that. But I think there's a little seven. There's a little seven at the beginning, isn't there, somewhere? Yes. Happy birthday, Tony Blackburn. He, of course, launched BBC Radio 1 years ago. Was it 1967, I think it was? And he also launched Capital Gold, 1548 AM. But my personal favourite was his shows on BBC Radio London in the 80s. Radio London. Oh, I love those shows. All soul music all day long, Monday to Friday. I think it was 9 a.m. till 12 midday. And I used to be working for British Telecom at the time. I had a little yellow van. I used to drive around fixing people's phones. And they were always so pleased to see you. You know, as the engineer, they were always so pleased to see you. Generally, you know, 99 times out of 100. You open the door, oh, I'm so pleased to see you. Come in, come and have a look at my phone. Which is completely different because before that, I used to answer the phones of the people who were calling in. You know, good morning, British Telecom Fault Repair Service. Can I help you? Oh, and they'd be shouting and screaming down that phone how important it was to have their phones fixed because this bloke was dying and there was someone in an hospital. All rubbish most of the time. Yes. What they were worried about is that they couldn't lift their phones and order their pizzas and takeaway food. That's what it was. No. But anyway, I used to be driving around with Tony Blackburn on in the background. And he is the funniest. Such an entertainer. Such an entertainer. And this is what we don't see on radio now. I turn on stations and they all sound the same. All these presenters, they've all been to some school somewhere and they're told what they can say and what they can't say and that it's got to fit within 20 seconds. No, that's not entertainment, is it? Tony Blackburn is entertainment. Old school, that's what we want. Anyway, apparently he's on holiday for a couple of weeks, but he's got some recorded shows coming up. And he does a lot of work now, though. An awful lot of work. BBC Radio 2, BBC Radio London, BBC Radio Berkshire. He's on KMFM down in Kent, all across Wales on Red Dragon Radio, all up in the north with this golden, oh no, what's that? The Hits Network, I think it's called, something like that. But yeah, he's got an awful lot of work. You might have seen him on Celebrity Jungle. I can't be bothered watching those reality shows, Jungle, Only Way is Essex, all that stuff. It doesn't do it for me. But he was on there as well a few years ago and a top entertainer. Happy birthday, Tony Blackburn. I kind of almost met him once, almost. It was years ago when he was doing Radio London and they had an open day. So I took, I had a cub group. I was Arcala, we will do our best. Yes, Cubs, do your best. We will do. Did you ever do that at Cubs? I bet you did, didn't you? Anyway, so I thought we'd do a day out. So we went up to BBC Radio London and we were allowed to go through the studios. And then we waved when he looked over. And he said, I think we got a message into the studio somehow. Maybe we wrote it down on a piece of paper. I said, oh, that's Chris with his cub group, Third Row Hampton, which no longer exists. Third Row Hampton Cub Group. And I think we gave him one of our woggles. Have you got a woggle? Did you have a woggle? A little one. We gave him a woggle, which a woggle is, you know, cubs and scouts, they have this scarf around their necks. And a little woggle is the thing what goes round the top of the scarf to kind of hold it together. So that's a woggle. Yes. Wonderful, 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 happy times. And of course, I used to go to the BBC Radio London Soul Night Out, which was, I think it was a weekly event or every other week, possibly, held at various nightclubs in London. I used to go to the one at the Hammersmith Palais, which again is that's no longer there, you know, the Hammersmith Palais. Do you know what that is now? Student flats. Yeah, student flats, purpose-built student flats. And I believe those ones are pretty expensive. You wouldn't believe it. They've got like a doorman, a concierge, all these computers in the area that you walk through, like a communal area, I suppose, for people to use. They look very posh. I haven't actually been in there, but I go past it quite often on my way to the karaoke nights in North London. And sometimes when I do the quiz, it depends where the traffic is. Sometimes it'll take me that route. And it's quite a big concern, you know. Yes, very, very Hammersmith Palais. Happy, happy days. I used to love the Hammersmith Palais. Me and my mate Dave used to go there on a Saturday night. And I think it used to close at 2 a.m. Youngsters are out till 6 a.m. now, aren't they? Gosh, 6 a.m. Why does anyone want to work till 6 a.m? Funnily enough, I was having this conversation the other day with someone. They were asking me if I worked. Now, where was it? Whether I DJed at the White Swan in East London. And I said no. And they said, well, why not? You're really good. And nice things say nice. And I never like to say that. I know some of you send in nice messages about stuff. And I get really embarrassed reading those things. Honestly, I don't know why. And when people come up, sometimes it's happened that for example, maybe I've done a karaoke night or somewhere. And so, can I have that? They come up at the end, you know. Can I have the microphone a minute? And you know they want to publicly thank you, which is lovely. But I can't take it. I can't take it. And I quickly turn them. Oh, it's off now. I'm sorry. And that's why sometimes if your messages are really nice, I can't read them out. I find it all very embarrassing, but very, very nice anyway for you to write such things. All right, my darlings. Let's say hello to some of the early people today. I think we only got through one, didn't we? Here we go. Good morning to, as I say, Gustav, Adam, Elaine. Good morning to Israel. Good morning, Elaine. Good morning to John Child. Good morning, John. Morning to Jerry, who says, I'd never seen your new countdown before. I hope you like it, Jerry. Took me quite a while to do that one. Do you like all the little diamonds and all that? It's very clever, isn't it? Adam, stop being so saucy at this time in the morning, dear. We can't have sauciness at this time in the morning. John says, how could they call you if their phones were broken? Well, they couldn't, dear. They had to send carrier pigeons to the British Telecom offices. I used to be the carrier pigeon collector. Yep, at 8 o'clock in the morning, I'd throw open the windows at the top of the British Telecom Tower, and carrier pigeons from all over the country used to fly through with little messages attached to their little skinny legs. Oh, skinny. Wouldn't it be lovely to have skinny legs? And look at these great big monsters attached to my waist at the moment. Look at them. They're massive things. Wouldn't it be lovely to have skinny legs like pigeons? It would. Actually, Danny Davis, who I think starts his new job today in Greg's the Baker's. Danny Davis put a picture of his legs on the other week. Well, I'm sorry, dear. That is pigeon legs. Dear me, he needs to eat some chips or something like that, or some more of those lovely pasties that he's now selling. Greg's the Baker's. Oh, yes. And I used to collect all the pigeons in and take the notes off, and it would say, oh, could you come and repair my phone? And then we'd give an address and then we'd send an engineer out, you see. That's before I became an engineer. I love that job. being a telephone engineer, turning up at people's houses. The elderly were fantastic. I used to love going to little old ladies and little old men's houses because you'd get cakes and tea and biscuits as you walk through. Honestly, oh, they were so... I never used to charge them, not the elderly. Never, I don't think I ever charged a single elderly person. Some of the businessmen were blooming rude. I used to charge them. You know, because in those days, it was really down to the engineer whether or not you should charge someone. You could use your own head. And that's until, of course, all the accountants moved in. They said, oh, no, you've got to charge them. Go away. Go away. You worry about your money, dear. We don't worry too much about money. Good morning to Sean Michael Crabtree. Good morning, Sean. Hope you're okay today, my darling. Good morning to William, who is in Sydney, Australia. Good morning, William. He does proper telly, you know. Yes, proper telly. Well, I mean, this is proper television, obviously, you know. I am a television... I am now a global superstar. Did you know that? Yep. This is, you know, if I go in supermarkets, you know, you feel people trying to touch you as you're walking past. It's true. Yes, William's in Australia. How warm is it there in Australia? We've warmed up here, you know. We've gone from below freezing to plus 10. It feels like summer to me today. I've had no heating on for an hour now. It's fantastic. Poor old cat. You know, she jumps on this stool, which is next to a radiator, and starts meowing, i.e. turn the heating on, Chris. She does. Meow, meow, meow. Like that all the time, she is. Morning, William. Good morning, Mr. Ray Reynolds. Hope to see you tonight at the karaoke, Ray. Elaine says, I have skinny legs. The problem is they're covered with fat. Oh, no, not. I think mine are too, dear. My legs are covered in fat as well. Thank you very much for your early messages there, boys and girls. Some of your messages coming in from Saturday's show this week, because we weren't with you yesterday. Wendy says, on the subject about Sky Television, we were talking about how much Sky Television costs you. And it's, if you have the top package, it's almost £1,000 a year. And I, as I said on the show, we used to get all this stuff for nothing. We never used to pay for any television at all when I was a youngster. Wendy says, totally agree with you about Sky. We had Sky for a few years, but got rid of it in 2013. Far too expensive and lots of repeats. Yeah, I mean, most of those channels are repeats, aren't they? I mean, there is some damn good stuff that that should be repeated over and over again, like Dad's Army. I mean, I think there should be an entire channel dedicated to Dad's Army and another channel dedicated to Are You Being Served? Just constantly on repeat. Or maybe a channel dedicated to David Croft and Jimmy Perry, who wrote some of these, including Dad's Army, Are You Being Served? Hello, hello. What's the other one now? Heidi High, they wrote a load of stuff. You could have a channel just dedicated to them. A laugh a minute, dear. This world needs more laughs. I mean, there's a wonderful comedy show going on at the moment over there in America. You may have seen it yourself. The Donald Trump Show. Every word a laugh a minute. Is he being paid to say those things? Oh, Wendy says, we just have Freeview now and don't miss Sky at all. Yes, same as me. I don't have a problem with having to pay for a TV licence either. In fact, I think we should. I think us folks of a certain age, also on a different subject, us folks of a certain age love vinyl. It's nostalgic. There's nothing like a vinyl sound. You're absolutely right. We love the smell and the touch of a real record, don't we? Now, as I said before, I actually dumped all my vinyl a few years ago now. Simply because you can get so much on a computer. You know, get a little box like that. That's in your entire record collection on there. Isn't that amazing how you can do that? So thank you for that, Wendy. Oh, my flat screen television in the bedroom, you know, the one I've been having trouble with. It's not high definition. And it's not, what's that called? You know, when you can do smart. I got a little box on Amazon. It was about 20 quid. Okay, I've now plugged that into the telly, and that telly is now high definition and smart with another box. So there you go. There's a little tip for you. If you want to upgrade your television to high definition, okay, but you don't have a high definition telly, as long as it's got one of those HDMI plugs in the back. You can buy a little box on Amazon, plug it in, and there you have a high definition telly. How clever is that? But it does mean you'll have to have another box on. Yeah, I mean, how many boxes have you got next to your telly at the moment? Let's see, there's a PlayStation, there's an Xbox, there's a high definition box, there's a recorder. Yeah, well, I've only got one next to it, which isn't too bad. I've no interest in PlayStations or computer games. I think they're an incredible waste of time. I really do. But of course, they are very popular. John C says, if you have Sky, Virgin or TalkTalk, EE or BT TV, you still need to have a licence, because we were talking about licences on Friday, as most people now watch more content online. It would make more sense that the content paid for, therefore you would only pay for what you view. Very well to say that, John, but if that was the case, it's a bit like, how can I explain? It's a bit like the NHS, right? Say you need, for example, a hip operation. Now, what's that going to cost? About £30,000, something like that. But whereas they spread it across everyone, obviously not everyone needs a hip operation, so you only pay so much. Now, it would be the same, surely, for the TV licence. OK, so if you decided, oh, no, I'm not going to pay for that. No. And then we get less people. So it's going to cost them more. So, no, I think the TV license is well worth it. We had a message on the YouTube, actually, from who did. Oh, God, what was his name now? Who did something? Hang on, let me see if I can find it. Who refuses point blank to pay any TV license and never has. Can't remember his name now. One second, I'll look it up for you. Everyone deserves their things to be read out. Can I find that now? Sorry, gang. If you put stuff on YouTube, sometimes I do miss that. Here we are. Hoodie Scum. Who says, I have no intention of paying money to a paedo ring at the BBC and haven't for 25 years. BBC is propaganda and lies. Thumbs down from me. So thanks for your message, Hoodie Scum. I don't think everyone at the BBC is a paedo. Come on. Not everyone. Not most of them. Not nearly all of them. Of course, there's going to be a few there, isn't there? As there is in the country, in all forms of life. One of those things. So thank you very much. Hoodie Scum, that's quite good. And he also says, play some Rolf Harris at your gig. I don't think that's very appropriate, do you, Hoodie Scum? I would be crucified, dear. Crucify me. Also, it's starting to sound like Jesus now. All right. Where's those messages? Let me go back to those. And John also. Oh, Joanna says, is the scan you're going to have, it's the same as a pregnant woman. It's called an ultrasound. Yes. Am I going to have an ultrasound scan here? Scan. It's not scan here. Right about here. See, from here, from there to about there. Because it always feels like I'm laying on something. Now, it has been going on for over a year now, but it seems to have become more permanent now. You know, when I lay on, though, I have to find a place. And when I'm doing that, see, I can't feel anything. Only that muscle that goes around there. And I wonder if it's something to do with my muscle there. I don't know. John, on the subject of mobile phones, says Samsung phones are much better than iPhones. I changed to a Samsung last year. Wouldn't go back to an Apple. Oh, why not? Why are they better? I've had an Apple phone for years now. And guess what, boys and girls? It's my birthday next week and I am going to get an Apple iPhone. Not a 7, no. The 7s have a real problem with their microphone. Anyone who has an iPhone 7 that calls me and they slightly move it, and you can't hear them after that. Useless. So I'm going to get an iPhone SE. Which my friend is going to give me. He's not going to buy it outright. Oh, God, I've got to put some money towards it, dear. I mean, what sort of present is that, dear? You know, can I not have it all bought for me? Oh, well, I mean, they are quite dear, but they're nowhere near the price of the iPhone 7. So I'm going to get an Apple iPhone SE, 64 gigabytes. And I don't know whether I should hold on to mine or hand it in as part payment, because I can get about £75-£100 for mine, which brings it down brings the cost down another £100, doesn't it? So that's what I'm going to get for my bet. We're going out next Tuesday and I shall be the proud owner of an iPhone SE. Yes! I'll probably get a new case as well. This case is just disintegrated. Look at it. Look. It's all for, look at it, it's all broken and falling apart now. So I'll probably get a new case while I'm there as well. Very, very excited. A new iPhone and dinner. And dinner for my birthday. She's going to buy me dinner as well. How excited is that? Thank you. Joanna says, I'm very fond of my vinyl collection. It's very extensive collection of Mr. Manilow's LPs and 45s. There's nothing like the sound of vinyl records. I totally agree with you. I totally agree with you. Joey says, what's your address? I will send you a birthday card. No address to send, I'm afraid to. Now, we used to send stuff to the two brewers in Clapham. But unfortunately, stuff seems to go missing there. So I'm no longer advising people, which means there's no address to send anything to, I'm afraid. However, if you want to send an electronic birthday card, that will be most gratefully accepted. And I shall read those all out on my birthday. My birthday is actually on Saturday, OK? So it's on Sunday. Thanks for your messages on the Saturday show. Let me see if we've got any more today to read out. And then we'll carry on with some little news stories and bits and pieces today, boys and girls. Adam says, Apple are the best. I think they are the best. I really do. I like the design. And of course, the Apple SE should have a faster processor and some other bits and pieces that I don't have on this one. This one is starting to do things now. You know, sometimes the screen goes off for no reason and stuff like that. Do you still have Katie, the Katie Cat Cam? I do have that. It's a tablet that I put down there. But I've decided not to have Katie the Cat Cam on too often because she appeared to be getting more viewers than me on my chat show. So we can't have any of that. Oh, you know, I've told you before, you know, she's an old girl now, my cat, and she doesn't make it. I don't understand why she can't make it to the cat tray to do number twos. She does the number ones. Hang on, which is number ones? She makes it to go to the number ones, to the wheeze. Is that number ones, the wheeze? I'm not sure which is ones and which is twos. I don't know what we're saying. She makes it to go number ones, the wheeze. She makes that to the cat tray, but not number twos. Well, the other day, I got in from work, and as soon as you open the door, you can smell it because she's restricted to the kitchen. Where's your? So I go, it's on the wall. It's on the bloody wall, higher than she is. How did she manage that? Oh dear. So out came the cleaning materials, and you have to clean it all up before you go to bed and all that business. It's one of those things, you know. When you get a pet is for life, not just while it's young and pretty. I, fortunately, am still young and pretty at my age. Elaine says, next time I hear the song Witcher Lineman, I'll think of you. Oh, that's a country song, isn't it, that one? A country song, yeah, that's right. There is a phone number if you'd like to call in this morning. The lines are open. Boo! The phone number is a local London number. It's 020-8144-3477. 020-8144-3477. You don't have to call in. If you're quite happy to sit there and listen to me rabbit on, that's fine as well. You know, we're not dependent on phone calls. But only if you want to, you can either call in on the phone, 020-8144-3477, or you can Skype in. Our Skype username is, all one word, United Kingdoms Talk. So phone number 020-8144-3477, or the Skype in is, all one word, United Kingdom Talk. Now, yesterday after church, I got back here. And I thought I'd do a live show. You know, I got up in the morning. Now my alarm didn't go off. I think I did it wrong. The trouble with the digital alarms is, you know, you've got, and I've got an alarm on my television. Actually, we've got a call coming in there. Good morning. Who's that?
Good evening.
Good morning. Evening. It's morning. Morning, dear. Morning.
Do you know who this is?
No. Speak.
Jimmy Butler.
Is that Jimmy Butler International? Yeah. It didn't sound like you, Jim.
Did it?
No.
Oh, well, I'm
where have you gone to now? You've disappeared.
No, I'm here.
Come back towards the phone, Jim. Towards the phone.
I'm in the phone, basically.
You were one. You came. Have you got an iPhone 7?
No.
What have
5S.
you? A 5S. I'm going to get an SE, Jim.
Yeah?
Yes, I'm going to get an SC. Let me just explain. This is my nephew, 19-year-old businessman and entrepreneur, very popular with the ladies, Mr. Jimmy Butler International. Yes, to give you your correct
Gary
title.
Gary Butler is here too.
Good morning, Gary. Gary Butler is my other nephew. Gary Butler, also international because he's been to France. En Paris, bonsoir, mon ami. Comment ça va? Gary Butler is 32 years old, father to three children who are also becoming possibly as mad as me. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Where are you off to today then, you two?
Off to London.
Oh, of course, you're down at the, staying at the Woking Premier Inn, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, because we've all got a funeral to go to tomorrow. My Uncle Terry died, actually about 3 weeks ago. It was about 3 weeks ago now, wasn't it? I think it was about 3 weeks ago now, just after Christmas, and we're all going to a funeral tomorrow. So these two are coming down to London, and they're staying at the Travel Lodge.
Yeah, that's the one. Yeah,
Travel Lodge in Woking. So if you want to meet the Butler boys, that's where they'll be hanging out today. Oh yeah, I've got to try my black trousers on, Jim. Dear me, I've got to try my black trousers on. I don't know if they're going to go round me or not.
They might not go round the ankles.
Have you just left?
Yeah, we're only in Anik.
You what?
You get done all the time. Anik.
Oh, my camera. God. Oh, my Nat camera around the corner there. That's got me twice, that speed camera.
just got past that.
Okay. Well, have a safe... Anything else you want to say?
Well, I was ringing up to see what you were doing.
Okay, well, have a safe journey. Jimmy Butler International, Gary Butler International.
Thanks for taking my call. Goodbye.
Thanks for taking the call. Bye-bye. There you are, my two... Oh, that was quite nice, wasn't it? My two nephews calling in there. Hang on, let me just add that there. There we go. Just add that on there so I know when he's calling in again. Lovely. All right, see, how easy is it to call in like that? Now, where was I before I was interrupted there? Oh, yeah, so yesterday, after being at church, I came back in. I felt incredibly tired yesterday for some reason. So I was going to go do a live show yesterday, and it never happened because I was so tired. Anyway, I thought, I better keep going for a while. And what is it I wanted? That's it, I wanted a lead. I wanted to get a lead, see if I had a lead up in the loft for my new HD box, which I've now connected to my telly. And I had to go up in the loft, and I didn't find a lead up there. But, you know, I don't know if you've ever been up in your loft and you stand there and you look around and you think, what is all this rubbish doing in here? And you know damn well, most stuff, once it goes up into the loft, that's it. It's like never to be seen again. Am I right? Have you got a loft or an attic or something like that? Huh? Have you? Well, yes. You know exactly what I mean, don't you? And I picked up one of the boxes full of wires, and I thought, well, okay, I'll keep that wire, and a whole box of wires and boxes, things like look, I have this great big box which makes one USB socket, I think six USB sockets. But this box was huge. And of course, these things aren't huge anymore, so I chucked that away. There was power adapters and wires, chucked them all in the bin. So I'm quite pleased I got rid of a box of rubbish yesterday. Stuff that's never going to be used. And there's a lot more up there. And I think over the coming weeks, every Sunday, I'll pop up there and chuck a few more bits away. So I came back down the stairs and I thought, well, it's lunchtime now. It was kind of lunchtime and I thought, I'm not really hungry. So I had a couple of bags of crisps. I watched a bit of telly and then I went back to bed at 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Isn't that disgusting? 1 o'clock in the afternoon, I went back to bed on the Sunday because I do get up early on Sundays. I get up early to go to church. So I get up about 7:30 on a Sunday. But the alarm on the television never went off. That's what I was telling you, wasn't it? That's right, yeah. Because I'd done a wrong setting or something like that. Anyway, and I went back to bed at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, got up again at 6. So I was still really tired and then watched a load of telly. Good morning, who's calling in now? London number. No, not London. Where's that?
Good morning.
Good morning, how are you?
I'm all right, how are you?
And which person is that we are modulating with today?
You know me very well.
Eh?
You know me very well.
I know you very well. Well, give us your name, then.
It's Joe.
Who?
It's Joey. You know me very well, Chris.
Joy?
Joey, yeah.
Joy?
It is.
Which Joy is this?
Millen.
Oh, Joey. Hello, Joey. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you today? You sounded like a little girl today.
No, thanks.
You do. I'm sorry, you do. You sound like a little... What's wrong with your voice this morning? It's all a bit squeaky.
I've no idea. Probably it's because I'm not slept. That's what it is.
Because of what?
Probably because I'm not slept.
You're not set?
Slept, like sleeping.
You don't sleep, do you? I've noticed that. Whenever I do a show, you're there. You are a non-sleeper.
Yeah, non-sleeper. I just never sleep.
How do you do that? Why don't you sleep then?
I have no idea. I haven't got a clue. I really haven't.
Does it annoy you? Does it annoy you, or are you okay with that?
It annoyed me a little bit, but not so much, really.
You're okay with that, are you?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a fair comment. No fair dues. What do you do at night? You play computer games yourself, don't you?
I say PS4 consoles and whatnot.
All right. My nephew likes to play... Both of them like computer games.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't remember. It's like an army one. It's very popular.
If it's probably Call of Duty or something like that.
No. Is it... World War something?
Modern Warfare?
It could be that. I'm not quite sure what it's called now.
I don't know.
But it involves army games, and they both got headsets on, and they can talk to people all around the world while they're playing it. Is that Modern Warfare? I don't know what it's called, but something like that. Warcraft or whatever. What are you calling about today then, Joey boy?
Not really what you talked about before, about lofts, really. My dad's just kind of the same. If it goes in the loft, that's it. Never be seen.
No, that's right. Have you got a loft where you are? Are you in a flat?
In the flat. I don't have a loft in this flat.
Have you ever been up to your dad's loft and seen the rubbish in there?
Oh, yeah. If it goes up in there, that's it, Chris. It's never be seen again until it gets up there.
That's absolutely right. I've decided, as I say, I'm going to go up there at least once a week, because you can only put so much in your bin, and I really don't want to take a trip down to the...
You've got to wait for the recycle guy to come and empty your bins and everything.
That's right, yeah. Unless you go and take it all down the dump on one particular day. But, yeah, it's quite easy. Just go up there once a week for 10 minutes, get another load of stuff and put it down. There's a load of stuff out there I can put down. I mean, really, there's a load of stuff out there that can be chucked out. I did empty it a couple of years ago for a man to go up there and do loft insulation, you know?
Yeah.
They were doing that free of charge. So get this. Now, when I first moved here, I went up there, but there was no flooring in the loft, if you see what I mean, you know.
Okay.
So I got some of those flooring planks and I nailed them all down. When the bloke come to investigate whether or not I needed loft insulation, because I had some, he came upstairs, he said, well, you'll have to lift up all that. I say, okay. So I lifted all that up, and then a bloke came to do it. He said, oh, you've got it already. I said, well, don't you put more on top of that? He said, no, we don't put more on top, because apparently, if you have too much loft insulation, you get damp on the ceiling. Did you know that?
No, I never.
Well, that's according to him. He said, well, we can do it if you want. He said, but you may well get damp. So I said, don't do it. So the whole thing was a waste of time. I'd pulled up all the floorboards, chucked a load of stuff away, only to have to put it all back down again, and they hadn't done any work.
Oh, my God.
What a waste of time, Joey. Waste of time. What are you doing today?
What are we doing today? Love anything? Probably not.
Are you speaking to your lovely lady there?
Yeah.
She's not doing anything either. Does she sleep?
Pardon?
Does she sleep all right?
You don't sleep well, do you? She doesn't sleep. She can sleep, but she can't. She wakes up during the night and it really upsets her.
Oh, that's awful. Awful. I can't. And there are times where I have difficulty sleeping and I don't know. And it tends to be when I'm off a night. Actually, I was all right last night. I must have been ever so tired last night. The thing is, I did a birthday party on Saturday.
All right.
You may have seen her on our karaoke nights, Kellly Kim. She's a lovely girl down there in Sydenham. And I did her birthday party on Saturday night, which it wasn't late or anything like that. It was over by 12 o'clock.
Yeah.
But I don't know if it was the way I was standing. I've got a bad foot this morning and it started yesterday. It's like where the arch is, and I wore trainers instead of shoes. I don't know if that's the cause of it. But I came home here. I wasn't that tired. And in the morning, as I say, I got up early. But I was really tired yesterday for some reason. After doing that birthday party. Yeah.
Are you feeling today then?
Eh?
Are you feeling at the moment today then?
Oh, I'm wide awake today, but my foot's hurting again.
Oh, Christ.
Oh, there's always something, Joey. As you get older, every day, a brand new experience.
Oh, well, yeah. Oh, dear.
Never mind. Well, thanks for calling in, Joey.
Okay, okay.
Always a pleasure. Bye-bye now.
Bye-bye, mate.
Bye-bye to you and your lady there. There we are, Joey calling in. Let's just put that in there. Type. Okay, that's done. Now, where was I? Oh, yeah, I was telling you about my time yesterday. So I got up about 6. I think I did some dinner, which was a Marks and Spencer's. Very, very tasty. I can highly recommend these. Marks and Spencer's mushroom and onion pies. But they've got a little topping of potato. They're delicious, they are. Really nice. I had some vegetables with that, and I did an Angel Delight. Now, on the packet of the Angel Delight, I mean, you put it in this little thing and it hardly looks like there's anything there, and you whisk it all up and it gets more and more as you add the milk, and I've got that sus now that I can do Angel Delight. What I was doing wrong before was using soya milk. Well, it doesn't work with soya milk. That Liam, wasn't it Liam who said it works with soya milk? No, it doesn't. It doesn't go thick. So I've done all that, put that in the fridge, and I had that, you know, the whole thing. Now it does it does say on the packet, serves four. You know, it doesn't serve four, dear. I mean, it might serve two if you're small. More likely, serves one. So I had that for pudding. And then I thought, well, I'll do a show later. And then I kind of started watching the telly. And then that was it. I was on the settee all night. And that's something I never, ever do. My mate Ron says I should do that more often because it's like a relaxing thing. But I never, never sit there on the settee. And I watched 2 episodes of Taboo. Anyone watching Taboo? Well, it's very good. It's a bit rude, to be honest. There's quite a lot of in it, you know. There's quite a lot of that. And there's a lot of swearing. And I heard the C word the other day. The C word. I couldn't believe it. On my television, on BBC One Colour. The C word. I bet there was a few complaints about that. Oh, shall we have complaints about Taboo? Let's have a look. Let's type that into Google and see what comes up. It's about BBC Taboo. How do you spell Taboo? Is it 1B or 2? Taboo. I think it's 2 of it. Let's have a look. Complaints about BBC is criticised again as viewers complain they need. Now this is a problem. This is actually a bit of a problem on some television programmes now, and I'm sure you've noticed it where the music is louder than the speaking, and you can't hear what they're saying. Have you come across that? I don't know who's editing these programmes. Another BBC drama has been hit with complaints over poor sound and picture quality. Taboo, starring Hollywood film star Tom Hardy, aired last night with many viewers taking to Twitter saying they needed subtitles because of the mumbling. Yeah, I go along with that. It doesn't actually say anything about the swearing, though. Swearing, let me see if there's anything there. No, I can't find anything there, but it is quite a lot of swearing and rudeness in there. Rudeness, dear. So I watched a load of that. Then I watched 2 episodes of the excellent Silent Witness. That's really good as well. And then I think that's about 4 or 5 hours. Did a little bit of cleaning up, cleaned up the kitchen, and then I went back to bed again. I went to bed about 11:15 last night, which is really, really early for me. I have not yet had a chance to hear the British entry, the United Kingdom entry, yet for the Eurovision Song Contest. So I can't comment on that at the moment. Hopefully I will do very soon. You couldn't hear the audio for the phone calls. I can see why now. I need to push a button. Sorry, you couldn't hear the phone calls. I beg your pardon. Dear, dear me. I've got a button here I need to push. Sorry about that if you couldn't hear them properly. Maybe you heard my... I can see you heard my side. I didn't have a button pushed, actually. Sorry about that. Oh, no! That goes for the recordings as well, I think. Did you? Would you have heard it on the recording? Yeah. If you're watching the recorded shows, you will have heard that all right. It's just the people on watching a live show couldn't hear the callers. That's fixed now, if anyone else wants to call in. Sorry, gang. 020-8144-3477 is the phone number, OK? Oh, thank you to my mate Ronnie, who's going to be round at 11:30. Look, he's put a message up there to collect us to go swimming later on, yes. Tim says, where's my Skype? Well, Skype in if you want, Tim. The Skype in is United Kingdom Talk. OK, add me on there. Skype in is United Kingdom Talk and phone number 020-8144-3477. OK, Adam also says, you'll be able to buy your crisps and chocolate from the BP garage with Apple Pay. Well, I think I've got Apple Pay on this 5S thing, but I never use it. Cash, dear, cash. Cash is king. Always remember that. Cash is king. Thank you very much. Yes. In the news today, look at this. Oh, here they go again. The politically correct people in this morning's Super Soraway Daily Mail. First, they came to us for our loos, insisting it was prejudicial simply to label them men and women. Then they came for our children, preaching a gospel of transgender rights in schools and playgrounds. Now they have come for our wombs, for the precious privilege of calling ourselves mothers. Yes, and I'm afraid it's a game changer. This madness must end. This is a story in the Daily Mail this morning. Call in if you want and comment. From now on, expectant mothers, in other words, pregnant women, are to be referred to as pregnant people. Not pregnant mothers, not pregnant women, pregnant people. In order not to offend the sensibilities of members of the transgender community. And it just goes on and on, doesn't it? What is even more extraordinary, says the story, is that some half-baked agenda deemed up by members of a student lobby group. And it's always student lobby groups, isn't it? But official new guidance issued by no less an august institution than the British Medical Association. In a new advisory booklet entitled A Guide to Effective Communication, Inclusive Language in the Workplace, the BMI's 160,000 odd members are informed that a large majority of people that have been pregnant or given birth identify as women. And it goes on. So what, you know, what next? So that's the story in the Daily Mail this morning. Ban on medics referring to pregnant women for fear of upsetting people, transgender people, is an insult to mothers. And that's been written by Sarah Vine. And I've got to be honest, I entirely agree with it. It's just ridiculous. It is just ridiculous. They are women, for Christ's sake. It is a pregnant woman. Isn't it? If you've got any thoughts on that, call in this morning. 020-8144-34. It's just ridiculous. I'm sick to death. Everyone's looking. I'm offended. Go away, because I'm really not interested anymore. It's got beyond the joke, all this offence business. It really has. Any thoughts on that? 020-8144-3477. Or you can Skype in. Our Skype username is, all one word, United Kingdom Talk. That's the Skype in username. Good morning to Wendy. Good morning to Wendy this morning, who's with us in Lancashire. Now, Wendy, would you be... Wendy, the question is, would you be a pregnant woman or a pregnant person? Which do you prefer as a woman? We need a woman's point of view, because otherwise, if I don't get a woman's point of view, oh, it's because you're a man. You can't be talking about things like that. Go away. Please don't complain. Just switch off. It's easier. It's so much easier. It really is. Good morning to John Scott. Now, John Scott used to be on Capital Gold with the great Tony Blackburn, who we mentioned at the start of the show. Good morning, John. Everyone missing me at the Golden Line. Thank you, John. That's very kind of you to say so. Why don't you come up the other place sometime on a Monday? You'd like it up there. And cheap drinks. Save a little bit of that pension money, John. Come on. Save some pension money. Good morning, John. All right. Another story here, boys and girls. What is your cure for a broken heart? Oh, God knows mine has been broken so many times into hundreds and thousands of little pieces. Do you have a cure for a broken heart, I wonder? Do you? Here we are. Some people are so devastated. It's me. I am actually permanently devastated. That is the truth. I am permanently devastated and unhappy. I am. Some people are so devastated they hide themselves away from the world while others fling themselves. That's a good word, isn't it? Fling. While others fling themselves into a life with manic enthusiasm to keep their mind off things. Everyone deals with broken hearts. Broken hearts differently. And now people who have been getting heartbroken have taken to the website Reddit to share their best remedies for getting over someone. The thread, which received over 300 comments in less than 24 hours. That's not a lot, is it? 300 comments in 24 hours. I get more comments on this show. Don't think 300 is a lot. Including tips such as taking the opportunity to go travelling to the less advisable advice of sleeping around. Dear me. Are you one of those people that sleeps around? Is it one a night? Is it one a night? Oh, shocking, dear. Shh. Don't, the priest might be hearing. Shh. However, some admitted that they had struggled to cope with the end of a relationship, and one entered a depressive hibernation, straining all of their social ties in the progress. How do you get over a broken heart? How do you do it? I've got to say, I threw myself into work. I totally and utter threw myself into work. And I've never stopped since. Although I'm still not yet on BBC. Still not on the BBC yet. I do have a BBC pencil, though, as given me to the lovely Ray Reynolds. Thank you very much. Here's some tips here that people have done to try and get over a broken heart. There's a bloke here, quit my job, went on a 2-month cross-country road trip and lived my life with purpose. It's lovely. You know, sometimes I see these, what's that programme? Home in the Country, that sort of thing. And I think, oh, how lovely it would be, you know, to just have that house. And out of all the windows, all you see is fields and nobody. Nobody. I would possibly have to get a few more cats for company, but no one else around. Could you live like that? Would it be very lonely? I don't know, really. I mean, you can be in a big city and be really lonely, can't you? How have you got over a broken heart? Call in and tell me. 020-8144-3477. That's if you're watching us live, of course. And if it's Monday, the 30th of January, 2017, and it's coming up to, and it is 25 past 10 in the morning, you are with us live. You can call in. 020-8144-3477. Another bloke here called Fred. I travelled to a beautiful island in Indonesia for about 2 weeks. It helped. One here. I took time off to date myself. How does that work then? Can you date yourself? How do you date yourself? After every long relationship I've had, I've taken the time to learn about me and to be comfortable with myself. And it takes time, especially since your personality begins to mesh with the person you were dating. It has taken me 6 months to a year to get to a point where I feel I am fully over the heartbreak and I'm honestly ready to take a chance again. Ready to put my love on the line with you. Oh, you know that Barry Manilow show that's been put back by a week? I'll tell you about that in a minute. Elaine, can you just let us know when it is again, my darling, and what is on? Until I'm fully over the heartbreak and I'm honestly ready to try again. I try to learn during this time so that I don't make the same mistakes and that I know what I want out of my life. Yeah. Here's another one. Never did. Patched it up a little, dated elsewhere, but deep down my heart is still in ruins. As mine is, it's been ruined and broken. Many, many, many people have a piece of my heart each. Not all of them, mind. Not all of them. Some of them, I took my heart back and glued it back together with super glue. So there we are. There's just some suggestions that how you could possibly get over a broken heart. Who's got over a broken heart? Anyone? Anyone out there? I'm sure there is one or two of you. Wendy says, I could easily live like that. That is my dream house in the middle of nowhere. Yes. The middle of nowhere, surrounded by beautiful fields. Perhaps the odd cow walking past. Moo! 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 Cows are walking past your house at this very moment. Adam says, my cure is Chris Reardon United Kingdom talk for my broken heart. Well, whenever you're upset, just put one of these on and you'll realise life isn't too bad at all, is it? Good morning to Shania, who's with us this morning, who is working again. Shania, you're working too much, darling. Although, possibly not as much as we think, because you're now sitting there watching this, aren't you, my love? Dear me. Naughty Shania. Naughty Shania. Thank you very much. Wendy says, yes, the Barry Manilow show is on the 7th of February. That's on a radio station in Israel. But you will be able to listen online. I'll tell you a little bit more about that closer to the day. OK, my darlings. Good. We'll do one more news story today, boys and girls. And this is something I knew was going to happen. And then we'll do today's birthdays and then we're done for today. Any more phone calls? Nice and quickly. 020-8144-3477. I'm sorry, those of you watching the live show didn't hear the other phone calls properly. There's a button here that I'd forgotten to press. But if you're watching the recording, you would have heard those okay. Now, this is something that I knew was going to happen. And I think I mentioned it when they first came out. 3D televisions. Do you remember? The entire world was going mad on 3D televisions a few years back. And I knew they wouldn't take off. It would be a quick fad. A few people, including my mate, would buy one, but they wouldn't take off. Here we go. If there's one thing on the BBC website this morning, if there's one thing history has taught us, technology fails if using it makes you look like an idiot. It doesn't mean, I don't mean a bit silly, like skiing on a Nintendo Wii. You ever done that? Oh, that's hard work, that is. Oh, there was no hard work when we sat there as youngsters playing Pac-Man or Space Invaders, was there? Like running around in Snapchat spectacles. I mean the sort of technology that when you look across a room and see someone wearing it, you don't think, wow, or that's futuristic. You just think, plonker. That's how I felt when Rory started wearing Google Glass. Sorry, Rory. And that's how I've always felt about 3D TV. That was the first nail in its coffin, the glasses. The second was the fact that it didn't really bring much to the TV watching experience. The third, it was too expensive, even at a discount. And the fourth, it was uncomfortable and, according to some surveys, straining many people's eyes and giving them headaches. Now, I actually feel the same. I feel the same at a 3D cinema show. I really do. You put those glasses on and immediately the brightness of the screen seems to go down, doesn't it? Now, the last 3D film I saw was last week when we went to... What did we go and see? Well, it can't have been that good, can it? Oh, I can't remember what I went to see last week now. Oh, yes, the Beasts, Unusual Beasts or something like that, which was a good film. But I wish I'd seen it in 2D because it just darkens everything down. So I'm kind of falling out of love now, to be honest, with the 3D experience in cinemas as well. It doesn't give it that much more. I don't think it does anymore, even less so on the television. This week, we learned that both LG and Sony have stopped making 3D televisions. The firms follow Samsung, the world's biggest TV maker, who confirmed the move last year, which means there are now no currently major manufacturers making 3D TVs. And I knew that was going to happen. The whole thing of having to get out a pair of glasses and put them on your head, it's just, no, it doesn't do it for me. Now, I have seen 3D television. Did you put them on? Oh, right, OK. But it's more of a novelty. For a few seconds, you're kind of a little bit impressed. But that's it, a little bit impressed. And it's just not worth the effort. And sitting there with those glasses on, that price-wise, I don't think that the 3D tellies are now that much more expensive than the normal one anyway, if at all. I'm sure there was a little period I went through where it seemed to be that all tellies had this 3D technology on them, but they've done away with it now and they're not going to do it anymore. And, you know, I knew that was going to happen. I totally knew that was going to happen. The only thing buying a new telly for me would be a bigger one. I've got a 50. I'd like a 65 at some point. I don't really need... I don't need a smart telly with Netflix and all that business on it, because I refuse to subscribe to anything like that. You know, I'm just a bit of a freebie, really, aren't I? A freedie. All right. Wendy says, I remember you saying that about 3D TVs. Yeah, I knew they were never going to take off properly. They were pushing and pushing and pushing those things. Do you remember? Oh, dear, they were indeed. All right, let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls. Where's those birthdays gone? There we are. Kellly Kim's birthday today. She is 30 years old today. Kellly Kim. That's whose birthday I did Saturday night in Sydenham. So happy birthday to Kellly Kim. Oh, incidentally, this coming Sunday, that's the 5th of February, I'll be hosting karaoke and open mic at the Golden Lion in Sydenham. We do one a month there now, boys and girls. Although I'm not sure that I'm going to be able to do the March. Let me have a look. I don't think... Hang on a minute. Let me just check. Because I've got a message here from my niece to inform me of something. Hang on. Oh, no, it might be. Oh, no. No, that should be all right. Oh, hang on. Have I got... When's that doctor's appointment then? Fifth. That's the 6th, isn't it? Hang on a minute. Oh, look at that. Doctor's appointment. Monday the 6th. Oh, that's the hospital thing, that is. So I'm sure it'll be all right. Anyway, so this coming Sunday, we're doing karaoke and open mic. That's at the Golden Lion in Sydenham, starting at 9 o'clock and finishing at 12 midnight. So that's where I was for Kellly Kim's birthday on Saturday. A lovely night. Lots of wonderful singers. We didn't get through all of them, unfortunately. We just ran out of time. So happy birthday today to Kellly Kim, 30 years old today. Happy birthday, Kelly. Rio Sanchez's birthday today. Happy birthday, Rio. Kevin Holland today. Andrea Galino, I think it is. Happy birthday, Andrea. Happy birthday to Lloyd-Paul Dixon, drag queen extraordinaire and DJ and many, many other entertainment things. Happy birthday, Lloyd. Have I ever met you? I'm not sure I've ever met you. Happy birthday. Benjamin Paul, little Benji, who won an award this week. He works in Harrods. Very posh. I like Harrods. I took my nephew up there for his 18th birthday. Was that year before last? And we had three burgers. We went to this burger place in Harrods. We had three burgers. He had a glass of Prosecco, I think he had. And I had a Coke. I can't remember what Ronnie... I think Ronnie had a Coke as well. 100 quid. Three burgers, 100 quid. But it was lovely in there. You know, the experience. And he met his football icon. Oh, I've got to get the name right now. Guy in Chelsea. Is it Drogba? Is it Drogba? Football player. He met him and he got his photo taken with him while he was in Harrods. So he was really pleased about that. Happy birthday, Benjamin. All right, 32 today. Happy birthday today to India Ryan, 15. Happy birthday, little India. 15 years old today. India Ryan is the daughter of my cousin Tim. And it's actually Tim's dad's funeral tomorrow that we're going to, and Tim's coming over. Actually, he's probably here now already, all the way from Australia. So happy birthday to India tomorrow. India, of course, so Uncle Terry who died, that's her grandfather. We're doing a funeral tomorrow. And happy birthday this morning to Sergei Dudnik, who's 29 years old today. Let's do the song and then it's time to go, boys and girls. Oh, hang on, I haven't got my song ready. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Here it is. Here it is.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
All right, gang. Happy birthday, everyone. Hope you have a lovely day. It's Monday night. So, oh, hello to Rod Brown, who's just woken up. Honestly, Rod, this show is getting early. This is almost a breakfast show now, isn't it? Happy birthday. Hello to Rod, who just joined us. Hi, Chris. I've just woke up as birthdays were being written. Watch later. Yeah, you'll have to watch a little bit later. Watch the recording later when it goes up. The recording actually is done on another camera. And it takes about an hour and a half to 2 hours to go up after the live show is finished. So as soon as the live show is finished, it disappears completely and comes back up in about an hour and a half, 2 hours as a recording. OK, it's Monday night. So tonight I'll be hosting karaoke at the wonderful Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. Starts at 8 o'clock. And finishes at 12 midnight if you want to come. 11:30 tonight. OK, so karaoke tonight and every Monday together with cheap drinks offers. That's every Monday starting at 8 o'clock and finishing at 11:30 at Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. Thank you very, very much for joining me this morning, boys and girls.